everybody, and welcome to episode 66 of the This Old Bit podcast. I am your host, Nina, otherwise known as Ine on Ravelry, Instagram, and Pinterest. And you can find show notes in the episode thread of the This Old Knit podcast group on Ravelry. So thank you all for joining me and happy 2017. It is January 1st, 2017, and I am coming to you from my delightful craft room. I'm using my phone to record, so the angle is a little bit weird, but yeah, you only see like to this part. It's a little unfortunate where it's cutting off, but that's what I got for you. Maybe I can back it up a little bit so you can see more of me. But anyway, I'm surrounded by stuff, and I'm sitting on my sofa up here, and I wanted to record an episode before it was too long. I think it's maybe been 2 weeks, not three, which is good, but I have all of the Christmas stuff to show you, and other gift packages that have come to me from people. Everyone's been really generous recently, and I so appreciate it, and I want to make sure that I thank everybody, and I don't want it to become such a thing where I have so much to show that it's like a whole episode of showing stuff. So anyway, I have several FOs and some whips to show. I seem to be casting on all the things now, which I kind of knew would happen based on just being very regimented about the Coffee with Cece Cow, which wrapped up at the end of the year for the knitting broomstick. And I did, spoiler alert, complete all of my items. So we'll see if I win any prizes or not. But just in and of itself, it's an accomplishment. It made me do socks toe up. I did a very large three-color shawl, and it was a good challenge, so it was good to know that I can do really patterned socks if I want to. I think probably this year is going to be a little more of the year of plain vanilla socks, and I would like this to be the year of the sweater more. I haven't knit any sweaters in quite a while. And I think that now that I've kind of increased my knitting speed, they should be much easier for me to do. So the ones that I did, and I have not actually completed that many, I started several, and then either I got pregnant, which obviously happened twice, or then I wanted to wait till I lost the baby weight. So first with Megwin, I had a sweater completed like down to maybe here. And then I got pregnant, and then I wanted to lose the baby weight, and about the time I lost the baby weight, we decided to have Joshua. So now I've lost the baby weight again, and we're not planning on having any more children, so it's safe for me now to start making sweaters for myself. And I would like to really expand my wardrobe of hand-knit stuff this year. Last year, I would say, was definitely the year of the accessory. So this year I'd like to make be the year of garments. So that was a lot of waffling. Sorry about that. So yeah, let's get into what I've been working on. So first up, speaking of the Coffee with Cece Cow, I finished my final pair of socks actually on the 24th or the 23rd. The 24th, I think, because I was able to do a Christmas Day cast on, but not a Christmas Eve cast on, which was totally fine. I was over the moon just to be done with them ahead of schedule. So for these, it was the I Love You More Than Pumpkin Spice were the final socks that I saved. I'm glad I saved these to last and not the strawberries and cream, which I forgot to tell you the story about last time. So before I forget again, I showed them all to you, and I knit them out of Homespun House yarn. I washed them the first time, and I always hand wash my socks, tepid water, and then I just very gently squeeze them out and lay them flat to dry on, our vents, because we live in, over 100-year-old house. It's 117 years old this year. So it has very large vents, so probably like that rectangle. So they're big. So I can usually put like four pairs of socks on each of our vents. We have a geothermal heating unit, so the air that comes out is not hot. It's just lukewarm. So it's like just air drying them, but it's a little bit faster because it is actively blowing. But nevertheless, regardless of all of this, they either shrank or maybe lost a little bit of elasticity, but I cannot get them over my feet at all at this point. I cannot get them over my heel. I tried. I was worried I was going to rip the socks. So they are going to live with my friend Disa, who has a smaller shoe size than I do, and hopefully she will very much enjoy them. But that was kind of a bummer because I put a lot of time and effort into them. But Disa's fabulous. She deserves some hand-knit socks that someone else knit for her. So I hope she enjoys them. Yeah, I wasn't very pleased about that. But I did learn from that that I had to add the extra stitches before I started the Fish Lips Kiss Heel. And now, the two pair I've made since then do fit. I have washed them, they still fit. So we're good to go. Yeah, these socks. So these are my I Love You More Than Pumpkin Spice, which I called my fairy pumpkin socks. They are knit out of Volandvine Yarns Footsie in the fairy hair colorway. And I really love this colorway so much. And she just dyed some more of it in her most recent shop update. So people who got that, you are in for a super, super treat. Because it just has so much depth, this color. There's blues and purples and mauve and like light pinks. And I even had a couple little flecks of almost an orange. It's just so cool. It's a very, very neat colorway. And my friend Andrea actually had said she didn't particularly think this colorway was for her, but then when she saw me knitting these socks in person, she was like, I must have that color. And she did get some in the update. So, yay, Andrea. They were 64 stitches. I knit them toe up, Fish Lips Kiss Heel. And I think I did 15 rows of twisted one by one rib for the cuff. I haven't woven in the ends yet, but I will. I haven't worn them yet. Let me show you the pattern. And this pattern at first was quite difficult, but once I got the hang of it, I actually was able to work it without the chart. And I chose not to do the pattern on the back because I wanted to really enjoy the color play of the yarn. So it is written with continuing this ribbing pattern here, which I think is a broken rib, is what it's called. So the cable sort of looks like a pumpkin. And I like that it has this little cable, and then it's got these little side cables. The only thing I'm worried about is if that's gonna hurt when I wear shoes, because it is a bit hard on these parts where it's a very large cable. It's many, many stitches together to make that pumpkin shape. But we'll see. So I haven't worn these yet. I definitely am happy with my decision to do the back of the leg plain. So see there, you can see that really pretty yarn. And yeah, I do like them. They're a little bit big, just ever so slightly big. I think I knit the foot maybe a little too large on the first one, and so I made the second one just a wee bit, I think like one or two rows shorter. So I'll just wear the one on my bigger foot. My right foot is my bigger foot, for those who are interested in knowing. I think we all have one foot that's larger than the other one. Or maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm just a weirdo. Always a possibility. So, I Love You More Than Pumpkin Spice, socks by Cece Allman. I have now knit every pattern out of the Coffee with Cece ebook. It is a great book. It's a great value for all the patterns that you get. And if you don't care about whether you knit toe up or cuff down, this is the book for you. If you don't like toe up socks, you might want to just buy some of the patterns in there. I definitely will knit some again. Like I really liked the, which ones were they? The ones that have like the floats across them that I knit out of my Hedgehog Fibers birthday cake yarn. That one is so cool. And Rainbow Ange knit a pair in a rainbow color. I think it was a Mothy and the Squid yarn. And it looks so cool with those floats. So I would love to make a pair of socks like that. So I'll definitely be re-knitting that one. The Espresso Macchiato ones are also a very nice kind of go-to pattern if you're not interested in doing vanilla socks and you have self-striping. It's a great pattern for self-striping. So I definitely can recommend it. I'm just a weirdo. I don't particularly love toe-up, if I haven't said that enough. But that's not any disparaging word about the patterns. They're very well written. So next up, my husband has been oh so patiently waiting for me to knit some stuff for him because he knew that I was doing this cowl. And so he was like, well, when you get finished with all the stuff you're doing, then I would like some mittens and some more socks because wears his hand knit socks. I'm sorry, my ear's ringing. Every day. And he goes to the gym, so he uses them at the gym. He has three pairs of hand knit socks. He hand washes them. He lays them flat to dry. He takes really great care of them. So he deserves more hand knit socks. I have like 30 pair. It's sort of shameful how many more I have than him. However, I knit them, so maybe I deserve more. So I did some mittens for him. I cast these on Christmas Day, and I finished them on the 26th. So they did not take very long at all. Sorry, I grabbed a bunch of stuff off my desk and something just fell down. Clearly, I grabbed a load-bearing skein. I'm going to put these on, but they're a little ridiculous on me, but I'll make them easier to show because my husband has large hands, obviously. So I used the World's Simplest Mitten pattern by Tin Can Knits. It's a free pattern on Ravelry and it's a really great pattern. So it is written for sizes from I think size baby, maybe? Baby size all the way up to adult large, which fit my husband. So and it is also written for all weights of yarn from fingering up to bulky weight. So it has like your cast on, how many stitches, how far to go. And then your thumbs and how to close up the top for all of those different weights and all of those different sizes. It's an amazing pattern. I highly, highly recommend it. It's really simple. It's just one page for the instructions, maybe two pages. Two pages for the instructions and then one page that gives you all of the yardages you'll need for the different weights of yarn. So it's great. As all Tin Can Knits patterns are great. I haven't found one yet that I don't like. And I own a lot of them. The yarn is from my stash. My mom gave it to me at least 3 years ago. It is some Briar Rose fibers. I do know that. It is Aran weight. That's pretty much all I know about it. I think it's 100% merino, but it doesn't really feel like a soft merino. It feels a little bit more like a BFL or some kind of blend because it is not soft really at all. But by the same token, you don't want to use a super, super soft merino for gloves or mittens because they're going to get beat the crap out of. And my husband intends to use these for when he's going and doing outdoor chores like chopping wood or playing in the shelter with the kids or doing yard work, etc. So they need to be really beefy. So the thing I like about it is her yarn tends to not pool at all, even though it's variegated. So this one is almost like camo colors. It's foresty colors. So browns and blues and greens. I did a 1x1 twisted rib for the cuff because I thought that'd be a little nicer for kind of snugging in. Other modification I made is I actually knit enough stitches to be like the worsted size of mittens. So I think I had 15 stitches on the thumb instead of 13 because my husband has really big thumbs. And then I picked up 2 stitches instead of 1 here when you join. And then I just decreased those right away after I knit 1 round. Then I knit to about halfway up the thumb. I decreased to the amount of stitches that it was supposed to be for the Erin weight, and then I did my decreases. I have notes in my pattern page if anybody is interested, but I think this kind of fits a men's thumb a little bit better. So if your husbands have fat thumbs or big thumbs, you might want to try that. So you're welcome to look at my pattern page and use modifications accordingly. Otherwise, I knit them just as they were written. And they're very nice. He loves them. I gave them a nice vinegar bath, and that softened the yarn up quite a bit. So there you go. Mittens for my husband. And that is my only other finished object. No, I lie. I lie. Next thing I finished is this washcloth. So this is out of a really cool yarn that I acquired 2 skeins of at Tuesday morning, and I'm actually going to go try and see if I can get some more because I want to get some for Disa to try because they don't have it in Sweden. But what it is collage riveting is what it's called, and it is made out of 100% recycled denim. So it has that feel of a pair of blue jeans. It also has this really cool kind of tweedy effect almost. Let's see if I can pick up some of the colors. You can see some little pops of pink, but it has more depth to it than it looks like when I'm holding it far away. It's got a lot of different colors in it, so it's almost heathered and tweedy. And you all know how I like a good tweed. I knit this up in about an hour. I was actually trying to time myself to see could I finish one in 30 minutes, but I got halfway in 30 minutes. So it's the grandma's favorite washcloth pattern. Very simple, knit on the bias. And what I want to try to do also this year is knit at least one, don't know if I want to say 1 skein of dishcloth cotton, or at least 2 washcloths every month. I'll think about that. But I at least want to knit 2 washcloths every month to send to Pink Hair Girl Knits podcast collection that she does for the Burns Unit charity. And if you haven't checked out her podcast, you totally should because Sally Jane is fabulous and her daughter Rachel is really great as well. And yeah, Megwin really loves watching them, and that is what she aspires to when we do our podcast together. And she actually said to me, I think it was 2 days ago, Mommy, how old do you think I have to be to learn to knit? Because I'm very interested in learning. So I think I might try again with her, probably not this weekend, but maybe next weekend, and maybe we'll do some washcloths because this should be pretty simple. And you actually have a functional thing at the end. So I think washcloths are really great. And this stuff is not as stiff as dishcloth cotton. So I think it'll be a little bit better for her to work with because I think dishcloth cotton is a little bit too stiff. And when you're first learning, you tend to make your stitches very tight. So I don't want to kind of throw that challenge at her in addition to learning how to knit, obviously. So yeah. Grandma's favorite washcloth. I think I've held that up for long enough. And my lighting might be a little bit weird because I have natural light. It's actually really nice outside today, very sunny. And then I also have a lamp, so hopefully it won't wash everything out too much. Those are all my finished objects. I do have my shawl that has been blocked, so I'll show you that. This is my coffee date shawl from the Coffee with Cece Cow, and it turned out gigantic. Like almost to the point of not being wearable for me. I haven't decided yet what I'm gonna do about that. 'Cause look at it. I mean, I put a video up on Instagram. It is longer than I am tall. I'm 5'4". In case you didn't know how tall I am, I'm 5'4". So this is half the shawl. Half the shawl is as big as my bow ties are cool shawl, which is my biggest shawl before this one. It's just huge. And then I have a whole other, basically as big, triangular shawl more. So if I were to wear it like this, and I haven't woven the ends in. You know, it's giant. I'm calling it my schlanket, but I didn't intend in it a schlanket. And like Mina Philip is hosting a schlanket cow. If I had gone in with the intention of knitting a schlanket, I might not feel as annoyed about the fact that I actually knit one. But I didn't go in with that intention. So I don't know. Do I double it up? Mean, it's not terrible, but here. I mean, that's still like, that's a below my waistband. So my waistband is here. Just to give you an idea of where this is hitting. It's just so massive. I'm thinking maybe I will work in the ends and I will use it for a shawl when we're camping. Because for that, I like to have something to wrap around me to sit by the fire. But Megs.
I wanted to show you something. Look,
Okay.
I threw it on his face.
What? Does he like it when you throw stuff on his face?
Yuck, he giggles.
Okay.
Well, if he makes a happy sound with
Hey,
when
hey,
that
hey.
food he comes.
My camera's up there, honey. You're gonna
Sorry.
knock it around.
Okay.
Are you gonna try to play your game right here? I think that's gonna be too noisy.
Don't worry,
Can
I'll
you
turn it down.
do it in your bedroom, please? And then you can still be up here with me. Thank you.
Here, Mom.
Thanks, sweetie.
Can I make a podcast after you?
Sure. Maybe you can share your American Girl doll. That'd be fun. Okay. Okay. So now that is truly all of my finished objects. And yeah, so give me advice if you can think of anything that I can do with this gigantic shawl. But yeah, it's huge. Also, this is one of my least favorite shirts. It doesn't quite fit me right. It just constantly is like wrinkling in weird places, and I kind of keep it for just wearing around the house. And it was laundry day, so I have been sorting laundry down in the basement with Megwin. We sorted five Rubbermaid tubs of laundry. So everything's ready to be put away now, but I'm gonna wait for my husband and Joshua to get home from the grocery store because he can help me like cart stuff up the two flights of stairs that it needs to go up to be put away. So then whips. I cast on four socks for my husband. And I showed you, I think I showed you the yarn last time. So I'm using Olin Vine Yarns Footsie in a Once Upon a Time Club colorway. This one's called Captain Swan. I think it's the only one she has not yet released. So it'll probably be soon. And here's how they're knitting up. I feel like I'm so far away from you guys. So I'm just doing 72 stitches. I did one by one ribbing for the cuff, 20 rows, and then, you know, just plain. That's how my husband likes them. And it's a little bit lighter than I was expecting, which is fine. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a dark gray heel because I was talking to him and he said he actually prefers to have where he can see where his heel is supposed to go so he can line them up because, you know, wearing heel flaps is kind of a different thing if you've been wearing commercially made socks for your whole life. So he said that having the darker heel flap helps him line up where it should be. So I have left over for my exploration station shawl some Madeline Tosh sock in the steamer trunk gray colorway. So I will use some of that for heels and toes. And it will go really well with the darker pops of gray in this yarn. But I really like it. I think it's great. And it's going to make a nice durable pair of socks for him. And he's very excited also. And while I'm in this bag, I will just mention the Thimblets. So I use these all the time for when I've been knitting a lot, and I don't know about you guys, but I start to get a little dent in my finger. I don't know if it's gonna focus. But on this side where I tension my yarn, I actually can get like a little raw place on it. And so these are adhesive, so they stick on your finger, and then you kind of conform them to your finger. It works way better than a band-aid. They stay down, they don't get caught by your needles. And so if I'm going to be knitting like a lot of hours in a day, I will pop one of these onto my finger and use it. And then, you can just throw it away when you're done. Sometimes if I haven't worn them for very long, I can take it off and put it back on the little, sticker board and use that, again the next day. But they are for sale on Amazon and stuff like that. I also use them when I'm cross stitching, so yeah, they're better than a traditional thimble of trying to put it over your finger and just have it flopping around. Oh, and that is in my bag that I made, so that is another FO. I made this bag over Christmas break, and it is with the fat quarter I showed you guys from Tuesday morning. So I just used the HeuLoco bag tutorial. And I popped a little key skein that I got from No Makers onto there as the zipper pull, which is the perfect size. And it's Christmas yarn. I think this one's fruitcake. And inside it's this fabric, which reminds me of those aluminum cups that you or enamelware that you use for camping. I'm really happy with how that bag turned out. It's super cute. And then, gosh, is that all I'm working on? No, that's not all I'm working on. Other bag. Okay. So in this bag, which I've shown before, is the Gibbum, aka the Glittery Blanket of Unicorns and Magic. So for this one, I am letting Megwin pick the sequence of colors, so I don't really know what I'm gonna knit next. She tells me what I'm gonna knit next. I'm using these 2.75 millimeter needles that I bought from handsomefibers.com. They are Knit Pro Symphonies. And they're very nice. I'm enjoying them. I think I got the 6-inch length. So here it is. It's grown some. I think last time I just had the middle part in the white. So I used, this is a Gilmore Girls mini. No, I did have this one and a little bit of this one. Okay, so I added on this one, which is Fireflies from No Makers. You can't see the sparkle at all. It's very sparkly. It's got gold stellina in it. And then we started into this one, which is Under the Tree from my Christmas socks from last year. And I kind of liked that this kind of goes into here. So there are some pops of that color in there. I don't know why she chose to go from this one to this one, but I'm guessing this is probably going to become her blanket anyway because she is so stinking excited about the idea of an all sparkle blanket, or at least she's probably going to use it a lot. that I'm happy to have her be part of the process. So there you go. And I think the next one she picked is this one, which is also from the Yarn at Home Mom. I think this is from the Gilmore Girls set, number 2. And I ordered the A Year in the Life set because I have all the other ones, so it seemed crazy not to have that one. She had a pre-order, and then she said she wasn't going to have them anymore. So I did pre-order it. So that should come later in January. Okay, so that's that guy, and then I just have a bunch of minis in there. And I ordered a bag for this guy because you can't have a glittery blanket of unicorns and magic and not have a rainbow bag. So I ordered from Pandia's Jewels. She was having a sale for Boxing Day of 40% off. So I ordered a rainbow llama corn bag, and I hopefully will be able to share that next time I podcast. But it's a sweater size because it's going to outgrow this guy really fast. Just having the minis plus the blanket, I've got maybe like that much space left. So not a lot of space left. And it's not very big cap. And then the last thing I've really been working on. Oh, good. I'm glad that's in there because I did want to go over that. Is my honey pullover. So, if you'll recall, I am knitting that out of, out of Venus Flytrap in on the Blitzed base, and I Will Always Find You on the Volca base, both Full and Vine yarns, and I am alternating skeins of the I Will Always Find You, and it's actually working out really well. I don't think you can really tell the difference between the two, even though they look quite different in the skeins. This is blending them very nicely. So I'm super pleased about how it's coming out. Let me spread this so you can see it. There you go. It's very nice. I am almost done with the kind of first set of body increases without giving too much away. You do one kind of wave increases and then you do a different wave of increases. It's top down raglan, so there's not a lot of mystery, but I think I'm on the 19th set of increases and I don't remember how many I have to do before I switch to the other type. And it looks ridiculously small, but that's because I have it scrunched up on a teeny tiny needle. And I'm only like, you know, at that point. But I did a gauge swatch, like I said, in the round, and it was very... So I know that it is going to be totally fine. I mean, yeah, like there, the neck can stretch a ton. Could be like a tri-corner hat. That's probably going to be the YouTube shot, because YouTube picks the weirdest screenshots for you to have in your podcast. It always picks ones that I look angry. Apparently, like, between frames, I have a very angry face. RBF, it's the thing. Okay. But yeah, I did, I started with a skein, I started with the darker skein, and then I did a strip from the lighter skein. Dark, light. I'm getting ready to start dark again. I'm doing the 38 3/4 size. So we've had some discussion more in the Volandwine Yarns group than in my group. I'm not sure how many people that watch my podcast are knitting along, but for those who are, there were some questions about what size to choose, and there were at least a couple of more busty ladies asking about it, and I chose the 38 3/4 based on my high bust measurement. So up here is actually 37 and a half, I think. But my chest is a 43, 43 inch, 43 or 44 inch bust, depending on which bra I'm wearing. So I went with my high bust measurement for it, and I have done this before on other sweaters, and I actually don't mind having negative ease in my sweaters. I think that's fine because then it tends to fit everywhere else in my body. Because my waist is kind of more in line with what my upper bust would be. And Amy Herzog actually has some stuff about this in her custom fit book. But she is talking about, like, don't pick for your bust measurement, because if you pick your bust measurement, everything else is going to be all loose and floppy and gross, and that's why people tend to then feel like, oh, I don't know what to knit with the sweater. None of the sweaters I knit fit me, because they're picking a size that's too big. So then the proportions for the rest of your body are going to be oversized. And if you want an oversized pullover or cardigan, that's great. Then you can just go with that. But if that's not what you're looking for, if you're looking for a more fitted sweater, then you need to go with your upper bust measurement. And you can always add bust darts, or, like I said, I will try mine on, and then if it's ready to separate for the sleeves and it's feeling like it's still gonna be too tight, I can increase up to the size for my bust, but then decrease right back down. And I think I have another book that was published years ago called Fitted Knits, and that is what it suggests doing. Is kind of making a Franken sweater almost, like some people do Franken piecing for sewing. Because you have all the sizes right there, so you can always increase up to the size that's the right size for your bust and then use the size that's right for your body. So you're sort of mixing up all the stitch counts to get to the right fit for you, because we're all different. We're not going to perfectly fit into any one size. So, anyway. That's what I'm doing. So I'm doing the 38 and 3 quarters. I'm doing the regular honey pullover first, and then if I have time, I will do a little honey for Megwin. And I have yarns picked out for her as well. So far, I think the only person knitting it in our group is Coddington, and I guess she has a really good chance of winning prizes, right? If it's just her, she's gonna win. So yeah, I'm really happy with how it's turning out. I love my color scheme. And yeah, so more to come on that. And I'm gonna pause here for a second because I'm getting a call from my husband, and I will record in a second. Okay, I'm back, everybody. Hi. So I went down to get some cereal for Megwin, and I had to talk to my husband about grocery stuff because they went to go to the grocery. And I got myself some tea. So I am drinking, or I will soon be drinking, maple apple cider tea that I got from Kristen. And it's dash tea, so I haven't had this one before, but it's a rooibos. I'm sure it's delicious. And I made some tea for Megwin, the Spice is Right, David's tea bags, because she said her throat's a little scratchy. So, oh my God, fingers crossed we're not going to be sick again. I will go into that in the end of the podcast, but suffice it to say, we've been struggling with quite enough illness, and I am ready for everybody to be better and potentially have a much more healthy 2017. So, last whip is another washcloth. I'm over halfway done, so you can see I've rounded the corner there. And I'm just, decreasing down to the end. Very straightforward. Another grandma's favorite washcloth. This is the yarn in the ball, so I've done two out of this ball, and so I'll probably be able to get four out of it, maybe more. I'm using a size 7 US needle. And yep, pretty mindless knit. Fun to do. Unrelated to knitting, I started a new cross stitch project. So I started the Christmas sampler. Oh gosh, I don't remember what it's called. From Frosted Pumpkin Stitchery. It's got a name. It was their Christmas one. Matches their Halloween one from a few years ago. I think it might be the Christmas Celebration sampler. So it has a block, 9 blocks. Each one has a letter, and then it's got a picture that represents that letter. Let me see if I've actually got a picture of it, because I don't want to show you the chart, which is, of course, what I have on top. I don't think I have a picture of the entire thing. I will definitely put the name in the show notes. I think I took those pages out because I didn't want to be carting them around. So, but the C is for carolers, H is for hot chocolate, the R is for reindeer, I is for ice skating, S is for snowmen, T is for toys, M is Mrs. Claus, A is angel, so it's like a little angel on top of the tree, and S is for Santa. And it has a very pretty border that's all in this hand guide thread that's very subtle, kind of rainbow or icy colors. Here, let me get a skein of it out. That one, oddly, I've got this white. I don't know why I have a weak Styworks whitewash. That doesn't make any sense because I don't need white. It's Weeks Dyeworks Snowflake. Let's see if it even picks up the other colors in there. Oh yeah, you can see. See that little bit of pink and blue? Yeah. I'm not going to focus on it, but you see that there's different colors, right? Okay. That is the thread that you use around the borders. The border is these just really pretty, almost like Fair Isle pattern. It's got reindeer and snowmen and kind of stylized snowflakes. I do not have very much done on it, but it was really fun to work on. And I can show you my cute needle minder. So I started with, of course, the hot chocolate square. Also because that's towards the middle. So I am doing it on Picture This Plus. What is it called? Cashel linen, I think is what it is. It's hand dyed and this color is gingerbread. It is not sparkly. My other fabric was sparkly, but this one is not. But you can see this very nice variegated coloring. It's dark colors. And there's what I have so far. So I've got the mug so far for the hot chocolate. The first mug has a little snowman on it, so I've worked the snowman part. And then this is part of the border up at the top. So I used that just for anchoring because he's right in the middle of the picture. And then this is my cutie cute needle minder. It's a tiny hot chocolate or candy cane mocha, peppermint mocha, or candy cane coffee if you're a Gilmore Girls fan. But it's really cute. I got a couple of them and I don't think I brought the rest of them up, so I'll show them another time, probably on one of my other samplers. And then I've got also the marshmallows in the steam of the second cup. And then there were two random little spots of white down at the bottom. So I kind of carried my yarn down there and did those two because there's no way I was going to do those separately. So I haven't done a lot on that, but it's fun. I do enjoy working on it. I got going on there. I might work on that a little bit today. Some C seaweed on my yarn here.
Hi.
Hey, Max. Okay. So, acquisitions slash gifts slash surprise packages. So first up, I will show you, because I'm going to take a sip, my newest mug. And this came from my swap partner for the Itty Bitty Knits Advent Swap. It's still really hot. Okay, so I got a Vancouver Island mug. And it's super cool. So this is one of the Canada mugs I did not have. Still too hot to drink. And then the other thing I got in that swap that I think I brought, no, I brought a couple things from that swap. This skein of Ultra Alpaca Light Barocco in this nice olive colorway. So I might use that for another pair of mittens for Josh, or I might do a pair for myself. It's very soft and squishy. So it's nice. It's 144 yards, so I actually don't think it would make a pair of mittens for Josh, but it would make a pair for me. So maybe I'll make a pair of mittens for me. And then the final thing she got me is this really pretty tea towel from the Canadian collection. So it obviously has maple leaves all over it, and it says Canada on one side. So I think I might try to actually make this into a project bag, which I've seen Kay from the Bakery Bears make tea towels she gets into project bags. So I know it can be done. I just have to figure out like what's the best pattern to use to make the most use out of it. So if anyone has an idea of like measurements to use so that I can get the maximum size out of this tea towel, that would be great. So, but I just, it's too nice to use as a tea towel. I think it'd just make too cool of a project bag. So, yep. And then,
Mommy?
Yep.
I think that would be good as a tea towel.
You could be good as a tea towel. Mm-hmm. I think it'd be nice to make it into a bag.
Well, we can wash it.
I know, but then I could use it all the time. And it wouldn't get spots on it.
It's more important to use things, use how they're supposed to be used.
Than how they're what?
For other things. If you use things for other things, not how they're supposed to be used.
Thank you for saying supposed to. That was great.
Then they could get ruined if you don't do the right thing with them. Like this tea towel, you're supposed to clean up tea spills with it. If you sew it into a bag, you might do something wrong and like rip it or something when you're not using it for the right reason.
Okay, well, we'll have to figure it out.
So I think we have to use it as a tea towel.
Okay.
That's a lesson I learned when I use something for the wrong reason.
Okay.
In class.
Okay.
That was a bad time.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you for sharing your worldly wisdom with me. All right. Then, let's see. I've got sort of a mishmash here of stuff. I'm going to move this over because it goes with that. So then next, I got a very nice package from Rainbow Anch, who I mentioned earlier in the podcast. She had done a Get Your Yarn Wishes Granted with me, and so she offered to send me some sparkle minis for my sparkle blanket. And she sent me quite a few, and they're all really cool. So she sent me some opal sparkle. And this one is not as rough as the opal sparkle I had. Maybe I just had a bad batch. Who knows? The Yarn Tree. This one's not labeled, but it's very pretty. More of the yarn tree. More of the yarn tree. I haven't tried this brand. And then Knitting in France, and she did her strawberry cream frappe socks out of this, I think. And she also included a pretty stitch marker that looks like a ball or a skein of yarn to me. And she also included a bunch of fun teas. There was a chocolate bar just downstairs, partially eaten, and some make your own puzzles for the kids, which they have not done yet.
Letting my tea cool off downstairs.
Okay, so thank you, Rainbow Ange, for this really nice package. I really, really appreciate it, and I love all the sparkle minis. I'm going to enjoy adding those to my blanket. Then my friend hey. Andrea, yeah, I just, oh, you put them all in the handle. Okay.
Yep, so it looks pretty.
Cool.
And all those little squares between it makes it look really spider-webby.
Yeah. My friend Andrea went to Texas over the holidays, and she was able to find some of the Katrinkles ornaments that I've seen all over Instagram, at least. And I really wanted to get one, so she got one for me and for our other knitting friend, Jen. So we all have one now. So it's the sweater ornament, and they are stitchable sweater ornaments. So you use, like, embroidery floss. Or cross-stitch thread. I might use some of my leftovers for my Once Upon a Time sampler. And then it has a little, you know, hang-up thing. But I'm going to put it in my craft room, and it's going to be up all year long because ornaments yes. are not just for Christmas. So, yeah. Thank you, Andrea. And then Jessica totally blew me away and sent a surprise package along with a really cute thank you note, thank you card, because she was my swap partner for the Itty Bitty Knits Advent group, and I had a ton of fun putting stuff together for her. She's had me maybe twice, I think, at least once over the years, and then she sent just random packages to us as well, because she's just so generous and sweet. So she put in some Victorian Christmas tea. That's a loose leaf tea. And then a bunch of different tea bags. I'm just going to leave those in there. But there is a bar of Maple Crunch chocolate. There are various minis in all different yellows.
Wow. This is beautiful. Mommy, look.
Oh, you used my tea pins. Let's not put those in there, okay? Because they're going to make big holes.
Don't worry, I'll take them out.
Okay, thank you. And then there's a couple that she also balled up in like a ball. So those will go in my Hexy Puff blanket. And I feel like there might be another blanket coming on too, but we'll see. We'll see what's going to happen. But anyway, so there's all the minis that she gave me. And then, oh, there's more tea. A throat coat tea. Paper. Okay, and then she gave me this little Canada stitch marker. My Needle Crafts on Etsy. She said she got some of these at a local fiber fair. And then this is my favorite. This little egg and coffee cup. Stitch markers from Studio Lou. Oh, I forgot almost the best one. It's a tiny gnome. Oh my god, he's so cute and wee. Love him. Look at his little butt.
He said butt.
Yeah, he has a little gnome butt. It's adorable.
Yeah.
Oh, so cute. Okay, and then, of course, tape measures. So she said she always looks out for tape measures in the bargain bin for me. Just because she knows my children break tape measures. So, I like this one. His little ear comes out. And then this one has a lanyard on it. So thank you, Jessica. It will all be well used and loved. And now that I've shown you, I can start using my progress keepers and put them in my box with my other progress keepers where I kind of keep everything together. Let me reassemble here.
That's why they're called progress keepers.
Right. They keep your progress. Okay. And then for Christmas, from my mom, I got a skein of Nakko yarn. I think it's Japanese. No, it's from Turkey. Okay. It is 10% alpaca, 10% wool, 80% acrylic. And it's kind of a gradient. She also gave me a one of those loop cowl patterns. I think that she saw it made up in this in the yarn store. So it's, I don't know if I'd say fingering or lace weight. It's probably a light fingering weight yarn. So that'll be fun. I don't know when I'll get to it, but it will be fun. And I like the colors. And then she gave me a skein of Madeline Tosh Tosh Merino Light, which I've only ever used in mini skeins. I've never had a full skein of it. And it's in this really pretty dusky rose color. It's actually the rose colorway. I think this might need to go into a shawl though. I don't. She bought it for me for mittens, but since it's a single space, I don't know that it would hold up very well for me in mittens, but I have another single that I actually was hoping to get a match with.
Hey, Mom.
To knit together into a shawl. So this will actually be perfect.
Can
to match
I
with
show
that.
Them this?
Yeah, you can show them that. This is my new pin cushion.
My mommy has a pretty pin cushion, and it's a cup. And, well, it's pretty because I put all the pins into...
And dangerous, too, because you have the pin ends sticking out.
Yep. Be careful. I have all the pins in the handle, so it's pretty. But I might need to take a couple out.
Mm-hmm. Probably the ones that are sticking out with the sticky points.
I don't know.
It's the white one, I think. There you go.
It's bent.
Yeah. Don't just leave it sitting there. Put it in a different part.
I'm just gonna make sure.
Here. Just put that in the body of it. Yeah, Daddy, unfortunately, when he sews, he doesn't really pay attention to taking pins out. Yeah, look at all those. Whoa. Okay, she made a crazy...
spider web.
Very, very dangerous thing here.
It's a spider web.
Okay.
Dangerous right, spider web.
Here you go.
Web.
Put that somewhere safe because I think Bubby's trying to come out. And then I got myself a teapot.
It's a machine.
It is. It's an electric teapot. But it's made of ceramic. And it holds 1.5 liters. I really love it. I got it on Amazon. Okay.
I want to do a coffee.
Oh, yeah. And the last thing I got from that package from Jessica is this skein of Candy Starburst colorway yarn from Tiptoe. Or it's Tiptoe by Studio Lou.
Tappy. Oh, I want to do a tappy.
I think it's going to be self-striping.
Oh, I want to do a tappy.
The little scene, Joshua. It's not plugged in, honey. It doesn't have electricity. It won't work. It won't turn on. Well, it doesn't work up here. Okay, we'll do coffee soon. Oh, do you want to wear one of these bracelets?
I want to see
You want to see in the coffee? Okay.
Let's see.
Yeah, it's hot water. Don't touch. It's too hot. Don't peel.
Okay. I want to do a copy.
Here, you want these?
I want to do a copy.
I don't need any more water. Thank you.
Joshua.
Thank you, buddy.
You
want to
have the bar?
You
want
a bar?
Okay,
for the interruption. He's probably going to be back, but I still have a lot of stuff to get through. So as part of the Get Your Yarn Wishes Granted, Harkness Angels also sent me some minis of her hand-dyed yarn. So, that's what these are. And they're also very large minis. So she is Willow Tree Yarn. And she sent me lots of pretty colors. So here they all are. I'll just show them to you in the bag so I don't have to take them all out because they're so nicely together. I love all the different purples and I don't have anything that color. So these will be really great to add to my blanket. They're very shimmery and soft. And I definitely will need to try more of her yarn in full skeins. So thank you, Angela, for these delightful skeins of yarn. I appreciate it. And then Annie Knitter sent me a surprise package as well. There was some candy for the kids, which is mostly gone. She made me this beautiful bag. So it is to use in Disa's Outlander Cow, which I think has started I think it started in January. And this is a very well-made bag. So, and you do a fabulous job. It's got polka dots inside. And then I love this for the zipper pull. She put little N charms. My name. And in the package, she gave me some sticky notes, some page flags, some hot cocoa mix, a beautiful set of Outlander inspired stitch markers from Exchanging Fire. There's a tartan deer or stag. There's a Celtic knot hiding back there. They're just really cool. And then an entire skein of Molly Girl yarn in the Diva base. And the colorway is I've Got a Feeling, which we listen to that Black Eyed Peas song like over and over and over again. And it's also sparkly, so I'll be able to use the leftovers of that in my blanket too. So thank you so much, Anne, for that. There was also a hot chocolate stir stick that you can put in your coffee to make a mocha, but apparently the children have taken that somewhere because it's not in here now. Those kids. Those crazy kids. I swear, it's almost done. The wool piggery is almost done. Most of it, as you notice, is gifts. The next thing I'm going to show you is purchase, though. So, as part of the Christmas wreath. Kristen came out with a new colorway this year for Christmas called Bûche de Noël. And it was so beautiful, and I really, really wanted it, and I tried 3 updates in a row to get it. And I finally scored a skein of it. However, I had to give up a skein of Not a Creature Was Stirring. But I'll get to that in a minute. So I got this skein of Bûche de Noël on the Narwhal base, which is her Superwash BFL silk and cashmere. It's a very nice base. I have 1 other skein on this base. Look at that. Oh my god, look at the speckles. Oh, it's speckle heaven. It's got these great green speckles and mauve speckles, and the base is like this pinky gray. I love it. I'm so happy that I got it. So I got that. And then Kristen, sweetie, sweetie that she is, gifted me a skein of Not a Creature Was Stirring on Sparkle, on the Blitz base. So I now have all of her Christmas colorways except for the one, or I have had in my hot little hands, all of her Christmas colorways. I've given 2 of them away. Holly Jolly and Deck the Halls, and I have 2 of them. Not a Creature Was Stirring and Bûche de Noël, and obviously I knit Special Snowflake into my bow ties or cool shawl. So this is Not a Creature Was Stirring. I love this one. Oh, it's got golds and these greens and this really pretty speckly pink and brown. Look at that speckly part right there. Oh my god. I love it so much. So, thank you so much, Kristen. Really, really. So yeah. Then, I had this last time that I podcast, but I forgot to show it. Cat's Kettle had pre-orders in her shop for all of her Christmas colorways, and her updates go so fast I cannot score a skein, try as I might. But this time, since she had all weekend you could pre-order and she was just gonna dye everything she got pre-orders for, I was able to get a skein. Instagram kind of knit up in a swatch, and I fell absolutely in love with it, and I had to have it. And it is called Put the Lights on the Tree. It's on her matte socks base, which is just a 75/25 merino nylon, 438 yards, and you guys. Eek! Look at it. Oh my gosh. And how it knits up is it knits up with this Christmas tree kind of color base, and then it has pops of all of these colors, and it looks like lights on the tree. So that is going to make fabulous Christmas socks. And I'm hoping that I'm going to have enough socks for next year that I can maybe wear one every, a different pair every week for the month of December. I already have 2 pair. So I just need to knit 2 more to make that happen. So I probably will never have another skein of Cat's Kettle yarn, because I'm just not fast enough. But there you go. Who knows? I lucked into the Jinx yarn completely. I just happened to go check, and fate had it that she had just posted an update, and I didn't think anything of it. I was like, oh, good, she has some. And then I found out that, like, everybody buys it up crazy quick. So it was just pure chance that that occurred. So that is my last skein that I have to share. Nope, lied. The last thing is, my mom gave me 2 skeins of the Berger de France Gumi 50. And everybody was kind of knitting this up on Instagram 6 months ago, maybe more than that. But it's kind of a self-patterning yarn. And I really like the colors. Danny from Little Bobbins knit some up. Several other podcasters did as well. So those will definitely be some really fun socks at some point as well. Okay, now truly, all of the yarn is done. I got this super fun tote, which is what I've been pulling all this yarn out of. And then Tuesday morning stuff. So I got some more fabric to sew bags. I'm going to try to sew a tote bag. So I got some upholstering cotton for that. So it's like duck cloth almost. I think this is going to be really nice for around Valentine's Day. So it's just green with these fun little flowers with hearts in them. It's 1 yard. It was $3.99, so super cheap cloth. So I have a tote bag tutorial that I got a link to. So I'm going to try that and see how it goes. And then I got another fat quarter set. And these are kind of just muted colors, so not cutesy fun stuff. But I really like them, so that one is kind of a pale gray. This one is a light yellow. This one. This one. And this one's got a light blue background. And then this one. The kids are bickering. So sorry if you can hear that in the background. I'm going to have to be done here really soon. And then for this year's Box of Socks Cal, I got my box for my socks. So here it is. It was 70% off. So it looks like owls making up a Christmas tree or a pile of owls. And that is what I'm saying, and I'm sticking to it. And then shiny little snowflakes on it. So like $2. But it holds a lot. Okay. And inside of it, I got some super discounted Christmas cards. They're sea themed for next year. And then another skein of the riveting. And then I got some fun office supplies for Disa, which I'm not going to show because those are going to go to her and I want her to be surprised. But I got some sparkly pencils, some really heavy erasers, and then these erasers. So, like I said, fun supplies for Megwyn to do her work. I finally finished sharing everything with you. So, for those who have stuck with me this long, thank you. And I will be announcing the Stashmas Cal winners separately just because I have a couple of different prizes to announce and this podcast is already probably going to be an hour at least. So I don't want to make everybody sit through that if you did not participate.
Just say goodbye and then let me do it.
Yeah. So I'm going to let you go now and Megwyn is going to share her...
don't jinx it.
Okay. Her thing she got for Christmas.
Jinx it means don't tell them.
Okay.
Hi, everybody. My name is Megwyn, and I have something really cool to show you. I tell you my name is Megwyn every day because you might have forgotten. I know you don't. So for Christmas, I got this cool American Girl doll. She is very expensive, half of a dentist appointment. So her face is dark. She has dark skin and she has pretty black hair. And she has a hat with a bow that ties it around her neck. A little cape to keep her warm on her shoulders. She has braids. They're very pretty. See this dress? If I could get it a little closer, you would see it has all the colors of our flag. Red, white, and blue. And these little hangers have blue, 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 white, white, blue, red, 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 white, white, red, 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 white, white, blue, 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 white, white, white. Okay. And she also has brown eyes. And her lips are darky pink. Kind of brownish. And she has pretty boots with this gray fur in her boots.
Tight.
And her dress is leather to keep her warm. Mm-hmm. Get it? Leather. This dress, it has little flaps on it. It lets a little bit of heat in. The flaps are like feathers. They keep the heat in her body. They're not like little openings where the cold can get in. It's like feather, so she can hold heat in her body when it's cold. And she has sweet mittens. And they're very nice. Okay, the American Girl doll is all done with showing, and now I have the wolf to show. See this little thing? I'm using it to haul her clothes. That's her gear, her other clothes. And the wolf, you see, he has a black nose, brown and white fur. He's white on his belly. And he has white paws with a little bit of brown on his legs. And his ears inside are black. He has black eyes. Yep, he has black eyes. And the inside of his ears are black. Outside of that, it's white. Outside of that, on the behind, it is brown. So that's pretty much all I have to show about my American Girl doll stuff.